Hey guys, this is Eddie. Welcome to another JavaScript lesson. Today we're going to go through the if statement today, which is pretty exciting. But before we continue, I just want to make sure that you guys were able to do this last lesson. So you were able to type a name into a text box and click submit. And once you click submit, what happened was the JavaScript program that we wrote takes the message you've inputted and puts it in a paragraph and outputs it back onto the computer screen. So once you're able to do that, what we're going to do now is slightly change up the form. So instead of saying name, I'm now going to say, so I'm editing the code, change it to 5 plus 10 equals. Okay, so save it, refresh. Now it says 5 plus 10 equals, and obviously you're not going to say John here. So let's say we say 15 and you click submit and it still says the same thing because we haven't programmed anything. So firstly, I'm going to change the text box size to 3. Okay, so if I refresh it, text box is a bit smaller now. And then I'm going to move the button to inside the form so that it can be on the same line as the text box. Okay, so see here, they're now on the same line. Now I'm gonna add in a piece of code inside the button just to tell the program that this is a button. So I'm gonna go type equals quotation mark button. Now that's very important for the rest of the code to work. So you should probably just have that there all the time. Otherwise, it's going to submit the form to be processed by the server instead of just running a piece of code. So instead of submit, we're going to now change this to check. So we're going to check it if the answer is correct. Right, so now it says check. And then in this output name, what we're going to do is add an if statement. Okay, so I'm going to say if y, which is the contents of this text box, right, from the previous lesson, if you remember, if y is equal to 15. And notice how I use two equal signs, and that is because whenever you just use one equal sign, it's going to put this number inside the variable y if you just had one equal sign. But because you have two, it's going to check whether inside the y variable the number is 15. If it is yes, then we're going to run this code. Okay, so I'm going to save that, refresh, and if it's 15, it tells me all of that. But if it's 6, okay, nothing happens. Right? If I put 6, nothing happens. Okay, so instead of saying that, I'm now going to say your answer is correct. Okay, and I'm going to get rid of the second line now because we don't need it. Okay, so refresh that. If it says 6, nothing happens. If it says 15, it says your answer is correct. Okay, if it says 7, nothing happens. If you say 15, your answer is correct. Okay, so I'm gonna make it so that if it's not 15, so that means the else statement. If it's 15, say your answer is correct. If it's not 15, say your answer is wrong. Okay. So save that, refresh, and now we have if it's 15, your answer is correct. If it's anything else, your answer is wrong. Okay, if it's 15, correct, 16, wrong. Okay, thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.